Life in sub-Saharan Africa is very dependent on the availability of usable water. Where rivers and lakes are not present, people rely on groundwater. Groundwater is the term used for water taken from the ground by means such as hand-dug wells and boreholes. Groundwater is a limited resource, and knowing more about it helps us to better protect it and manage its use.
But what is the best way to get to the precious groundwater?
Hello! My name is H2O, and I'm here today to tell you more about drilling for groundwater. Did you know that deep beneath your feet are great reservoirs of water stored there through years of water infiltration? And the best way we know to get to it is to drill. In many cases, the groundwater we get from our boreholes comes from far away. Much of the quality groundwater here in northern Namibia comes from Angola and gathers in a massive underground water reservoir in the Kubalai-Itosha Basin. The problem is that the water in the Kubalai-Itosha Basin is well hidden and very, very deep. Hydrogeologists, people who specialize in finding groundwater, mark a location for drilling which has a high potential for finding groundwater. The groundwater is much deeper than we can dig ourselves, and sometimes below very hard layers of stone. That is why we use big mechanical drills. These drilling machines come in many shapes and sizes, but they all do the same thing: drill for water. The high tower you see is where the rods are added to drill very deep. Each rod is fitted to the last as the drill goes deeper and deeper, so the borehole can be much deeper than the tower is high. While the drill is busy, the hydrogeologist does sample tests to know when the water table or relevant aquifer has been reached. Like a layer cake, Earth has many layers. Sometimes an aquifer with a larger water reservoir lies below a smaller one, and the drill needs to keep on drilling through the top layer to get to the one below. Here in Namibia, that can be several hundred meters deep. Once the drill is at the optimal depth, the rods and the drill bit are removed and replaced with a casing which will carry the water to the surface, much like a straw in a glass. On the surface, a well top and a fence is installed to keep the well protected. A pipeline from the borehole ensures that the water can be accessed outside the safe zone to ensure the continued protection of the borehole. Finally, a pump test is conducted by the hydrogeologist to determine the capacity or yield of the borehole and also to test the water purity and for possible pollutants. The collected data is processed and forms part of a large model which tells us how much water is in reserve, how much can be used over time, and how water can be distributed fairly. Water is valuable, so we must all work together to protect it. And remember, be water wise!